Find all five.
What is it enough for me?
It's a puzzle, it's like you would strike out one notice. No one aware, no one running up to a pit. Last goal, no, last time we got our answers. While we in America slug, the first blood tip was around a small town in Little Mexico. We've been waiting several hours for this false story. Now we're finally ready to go.
While we offer intention of the title of right-hand club, a community suddenly thrust into the prominence of the first two ticket finder. This lucky finder is the son of our most prominent Bob Butcher. The boy's name, Agusa Blue, the Bronze Cobra, the famous Southeastern Mexico. How does it make you feel to be the first golden ticket finder?
I'm ready.
And our feelings?
Sorry for Wanda, it's really comfortable to watch this play.
Ms. Blue, can you get us a few words to the audience?
Yes, I know
that
Agusa will get the door this evening.
Happy birthday, Charlie!
Hey.
Thank you. It's terrific.
And here's a gift from me, Charlie.
I think I know what that is. It's a Wonka.
Now go on, Charlie. Open it. Let's see that golden ticket.
Wouldn't that be fantastic?
Never mind that. Go on. Open it, Charlie.
Well, I'm not seeing anyone else open.
You've got more, Charlie, because you want more. Now go on. Open it.
All right, here it goes. I got it.
Wait, where?
Fooled you, didn't I? Sorry, I really had it.
Don't worry.
Here, let me have a little bite.
No. You.
I
know, Angel, I got my little
phone.
It's not hunting for you. We're doing our best.
Oh my goodness, where is it? And why haven't they found it?
Veruca, sweetheart, I'm not a magician. Give me time.
But I want it now. So bad when those perks down here.
For 5 days now, they've been. They've been unwrapping chocolate bars for 5 days. They haven't shoved a peanut out of there since Monday. They've been unwrapping flaming chocolate bars from dawn till dusk. All right, you people, put a jacket in. Move faster. It'll be out on your ears, every single one of you. And listen to this. The first one to find the golden ticket gets £1 bonus in their pay bucket. What do you think of that?
Yay! They're not gonna try. They don't want to find it. They're jealous of me.
I can't push them any harder. Earth, they're showing 19,000 bars an hour. Last I checked, they've unwrapped 760,000 of those things. Veruca, sweetheart, angel. There's only 4 golden tickets left, and the whole bloody world is hunting for them. What can I do?
The golden ticket is gone. There it is.
I have time too. I want it. Give me that ticket. It's mine. I found the golden ticket.
Thank you for that.
And it can happen right here too. I'm believing what it sounds right here in America. Way even in the smallest town, the happiest of the dream come true. Because, well, here she is, Miss Vanda Morrigan. Find out who the Mocha ticket number 34 has seen in Montana. A good word of our parents, Mrs. Morrigan.
These are just over 263 medals and trophies around the first
world. Father, should she get sent to the nation?
Sure will. Here it is, golden ticket number 3, and it's all mine.
Does that happen, Violet?
Well, I'm a gum chewer, normally. But when I heard about these ticket things among us, I let out the gum and sushi candy bars instead. Now, I'm right back to gum. I chewed all day except on meal times when I stick it behind my ear. She's just a very good woman. I don't know what she can do. Now, this piece of gum here I've been chewing for 3 months solid, and that's a world record. It's being the record held by my best friend, Miss Cornelia Prince Medal, and was she mad? Hi, Cornelia, how are you, sweetie? So we see that one kid's gonna get this big special prize. I don't care who goes for it, that kid's gonna be me. Tell him bye bye then, because I'm a winner.
Okay, well, I guess I'll be going.
Well, I don't know what that means.
Here, I have what I feel about.
here. Golden, I want to catch this. Hey, can you tell us?
Four down and one to go. And somewhere out there, another looking person is moving closer and closer to find the last thing that saw prices in history. A woman cannot know the remedy of what it is. And surely you might fear on our losing. You must remember there are many more important things. Many more important things. Offhand, I can't.
I told you, Charlie, this is more important to me. Now go on, one more ticket left. Let's see it.
No, Grandpa, you do it. I can't.
Something tells me we're going to move up this time. I've got a funny feeling inside. Which end shall I open at first?
Yeah, I just moved it.
Like this?
And I'm born.
No, you do it. I can't.
No, Grandpa, you do it.
Okay, here goes.
That's it. It's all over. The Wonka contest is all over. The final ticket has been found. And now we have a lot of people coming in.
It's finished. The end has come. The fifth and last building together will come right here in Paraguay. The lucky founders of Brooklyn, Minnesota. He's the multi-millionaire owner of gambling casinos throughout South America. Here's a recent photo of Roberto, the lucky founder. He's the man that put an end to Wonka Mania for the whole world.
Turn it off! Well, that's that. No more golden tickets. I feel sorry for Charlie. The little boy needs something in this whole world to hope for. What's he got to hope for now?
That's not what we can do. We don't want him now.
Yeah, let him breathe. Let him have one last.
Congratulations, little boy. You found the fifth golden ticket. May I introduce myself?
Arthur Slavin, president of Slavin Chocolate Incorporated. Now listen carefully, I'm going to be very rich. Mr. Wong has at this moment a fantastic invention, an everlasting lobster. If he succeeds, you're ruined. So what I want to do is to have all of this one everlasting lobster.
Don't lie to us, Charlie. There aren't any more golden tickets.
No, Grandpa. The last one's a fake. It says from the papers. See for yourself.
Greetings to you, lucky finder of this golden ticket from Mr. Willy Wonka. Present this ticket at the factory gates at the first day of October, and do not be late. You may bring with you one member of your own family. But Charlie, you've done this. I'm ready. I'm fine.
This is a big day. It's Thursday, or Julie Wonka's
we want to witness the greatest of them all. Let's go where you are.
Thank you, welcome my friends. Welcome to my chocolate factory. Would you step forward, please?
Ruka first, get that ball, you go on, shoot.
We're gonna have such an exciting day. We're gonna love it, so just love it, please. I hope you will. With the holders and golden tickets, please step forward. Ruka, how lovely to meet you. And how pretty you look in that nice and cozy. Mr. Song, just over there, sir. Augusta, my dear boy. How nice to meet you, man. Such a fine shape. And Mrs. Wu. What a nice little boy you have. Darling child, welcome to Mocha.
How are you doing, Daddy?
Charming.
Hi, Mike.
Mike, how nice to see you, Mike. And this must be Mrs. Wu. What a terrific little boy you have,
Mrs. Charlie Puffin.
Well, well, Charlie Puffin. I've heard all about you in the papers. And who might this be?
That's my grandma, Grandpa Joe.
Grandpa Joe. Glad you're here. Come over, Charlie. Trent! Okay, everybody ready? On. In we go.
Thank you.
and chocolate. You know, no other factor in the world mixes with chocolate waterfall, but it's the only way if you want to get into just right.
Bombs and bananas, Charlie. How do you know it's a chocolate?
I've never seen one with such a strange colorful optics. Unlooking people are there.
What is he there?
They must be creaming and sugaring them.
Well, they can't be real people.
Well, of course they're real people.
Stop the nonsense.
No, Oompa Loompas.
Oompa Loompas!
From Loompa Land.
Loompa, there's no such place.
Excuse me, dear lady.
You saw a hot joke of the teacher.
Oh, well, then you know all about it. What a terrible place it is. Nothing but desolate wastes and fierce beasts. The Bluebird did eat nothing for lunch. I went to it, I think nothing of it. And so I said, come live with me in peace and harmony, away from all the wang doodles and corn smugglers and snozzlingers and rotten pernicious canids.
Snozzlingers? Pernicious canids? What kind of rubbish is this?
I'm sorry, but all questions must be submitted in writing. And so, in the greatest of secrecy, I transported the entire population of Bluebirds to my factory right here.
Alright, I'll get you an Oompa Loompa before the day is out.
No, I want them now! I'm killing you, Nick!
This stuff is terrific. Grapple them as
well. Oh, don't worry, we can't drink it all.
I
guess so. Please, please don't do that. My child has never been touched by human hands and be contaminated. I guess so, please. Please stop! I guess so, don't do that!
Help!
Marshall!
Help!
And beautiful chocolate.
What is happening? Do something!
It's too late now.
Too late?
The suction's gone. Watch the pipe!
How long is it going to take now, Greg? He can swim!
You better not to learn! Everybody aboard? Y'all are gonna love this. Just love it!
Hey, Dad, I remember this.
raining? Is it snowing? Is a hurricane blowing? God is like the fire children, so the rain must be flowing. Are the fires of hell blowing? Is the frozen reaper blowing? Yes! The world of people are growing, and the German left is showing signs that they are slowing. Is the danger growing?
Why?
What's happening to your face?
to the juicing room. At once, please.
But my little girl.
What for?
For juicing. It's a fairly simple operation.
Really? Doesn't seem like it.
Nothing to worry about. It won't hurt a thing.
Use it!
everybody got what you want.
What's that?
Veruca went first.
Mr. Wonka, they won't actually be burning the furnace, will they?
Well, to think of it, we only light the furnace every other day, so they're a good sporting chance, but I don't think.
There are no worries.
he doesn't.
Why?
Because he cheated.
What do you mean, cheated?
Well, he cheated. You stole because he looked at her.
We didn't steal.
No.
Wrong, sir, wrong.
According to Section 37B of the contract he signed, it states that quite clearly that all offers shall become null and void if, and you can read it right here in this photostatic copy, I, the undersigned, have forfeited all rights, privileges, and licenses herein and herein contained, etc., etc., fax unitis, insignium, gloria, capitulum, etc., etc., memo bis plenum delicata. It's all there, black and white, clear as crystal. You stole his lifting drink, sir. You damaged the ceiling, which now has been sterilized, repaired, and properly cleaned. You spent months of work on, like, that is terrible. You lose, sir, you lose.
How could you do this? Roll up a little boy's dream like this and crush it into a million pieces.
I said good day, sir.
Okay, even if that's the last thing I'll do, let's get out of here, Charlie. Slumber wants one of those everlasting jobs, Slumber.
Yo, back him up.
Where are you going, Johnny? Why do you do this?
Why? So shines a bright light in the weary world. Charlie, you did it. You won.
Won what, the chocolate?
That's the chocolate, Charlie. It's so much more. I'd like to meet somebody. Charlie, meet Mr. Wilkinson.
Slumber?
No, Charlie. It's Mr. Wilkinson. He works for me.
For you?
For me. I'm so sorry, Charlie, but I had to test you. There's no other way to go about it. I had to make sure that no one steals my most precious invention. And it was much more than that, Charlie. See, a while ago, I was sitting in my office thinking, what will happen when I die?
It's a common thing.
So I said, who will replace me?
I can hire an accountant or a lawyer,
but that's not what you do. They have no idea how to run a chocolate factory properly. But the chocolate would turn terrible. It would be hurt. It would be like baking chocolate. Can't have that. And so I said the child should run the chocolate factory. That's why I'm giving it to you, Charlie.
To me? How about the rest of my family?
They can come too, of course.
Yes.
But you know what happens to the man they went with before?
What happened?
You lived happily ever after.